All righty, so we will be moving on to Georgia State Senate District 8. First one to speak, Ellis Black, Republican. Are you here? So next we will have, again for Georgia State Senate District 8, Mr. Gregory Williams from the Democratic Party.
Hello everyone, how y'all doing?
Good.
Good to see you all, good to see you all. As mentioned, I am Gregory Williams and I am running for District 8 State Senate. Give you a little bit of information about District 8. District 8 consists of 7 counties and 15 cities. Those 7 counties is among a 6-minute time frame. I'll just give them to you briefly. But that's Lowndes County, Cook County, Brooks County, Thomas County, Clinch County, Eccles County, and Lanier County. So I ask that all my fellow Democrats, if you have family and friends in those counties, reach out to them and let them know Gregory Williams is their state senator. I would like to start off my speech just by briefly giving a piece of advice that was given to me. An old wise man once told me, at the end of the day, always remember, you're the one running. Everybody's gonna have something to say about how you look, the way you talk, the way you dress, what you do. However, at the end of the day, you're the candidate. So what that did for me is that made me take a sit back and just kind of look at myself like, hey, what does that mean to me? After studying that for a while, I was like, I'm a scientist. So I dig a little bit too deep. And what that did is that led me to a 2-word campaign slogan that I'm going to share for the first time here tonight. That 2-word campaign slogan is community first. That is my platform. And by community first, what that means is that means I go out to the community. I'm a servant in the community. I continue to serve my community, and I want the community to serve while I serve. Things of that sort lead me to want to kind of question the candidates that I've already met, the candidates that I'm running against. And what I've noticed is there are some trends. A lot of things are similar, a lot of things are different. But what we need for South Georgia is we need progressive leaders. We need leaders who are going to take action. We need transformational leaders. And I'm all of that. I've surveyed myself several times, over and over and over. Am I the man for the job? Am I the man for the job? Question myself. But when I look at my actions speak louder than any words I can ever say. I'll give you a couple examples. This past summer, all 7 counties that I run for, I actually volunteered to feed the kids in those counties this whole summer. I challenge you to go to Google and type in WCTV Feed the Kids. There's a video, there's a link, there's everything. It was posted back July 28th of this year. A lot of people missed it, but being that I am a community person, I do things of that sort without looking for recognition. That's what I've done all year. That's what I'll continue to do, win or lose. I'm always in the community. I started a nonprofit organization to assist me in the community. And the biggest thing with my nonprofit organization is everything we do and everybody that's a part of it, it's all volunteers. And if you know about dealing with volunteers, you understand how it is to work and serve the people. Because volunteers, they don't get paid. They have to spend a lot of their time, blood, sweat, and tears, making things happen for the organization, for the community, without getting anything in return. So I challenge my volunteers to tell them all the time, hey, the event itself, the outcome of the event, the growth of our events, that's your reward. So that's kind of just giving you guys a brief, kind of quick, all in a nutshell, some of me, my interns, how I operate. So as your state senator candidate, I operate the same. So what I've been doing over the last course of months is I've been reaching out to people who are professionals at what they do. Because when things come on the table that requires a professional opinion, I'm not a professional in everything. I'm gonna reach out to the people. And back in March, when I signed my name on that paper for candidate to qualify for this, a couple of people reached out to me just by me putting my name on it. And some of those people, I'll give you one example, the Animal Rights Society of Lowndes County. They reached out to me, and they've been my best friends since March. I didn't know some of these people are some of the best people here in the city. So what I've done is I go to everything they invite me to. I show up. I speak up for them. I'm there. There's a video out where my opponent actually kind of went against this organization here in Lowndes County. Another reason why that organization reached out to me. There's other organizations that I also volunteer and spend time with. I'll give you one more example because she's here in the room. Ms. Gretchen, Quarterman, and John. They have a watershed coalition project that I always, anytime I can get there, I'm there. They cleaned up the river. The Lapa River this past Saturday. I was unfortunate to attend, but I am on the roster to clean up rivers with them throughout the rest of the year. And I just want to say this venue here is kind of makes me want to sit back and soak it in, because this is where my political professional career began. Here back in 2008, I was one of the two campus coordinators for the Obama campaign administration here in Lowndes County. There was only two of us. I was one of two. The Democratic Party here gave me a pamphlet full of all of our registered voters, where to find them, how to meet them, and I went out and find them. During that election, that was the first time in a long time, if I can state back how long, Georgia turned blue in almost every field. And I was a part of that, just being out volunteering, doing my thing. So I want to commend all the candidates who've reached out and talked about service, because that is the most important part. That's what our voters pay attention to. I know me being a registered voter now for about 15 years, that's what I look for every campaign I voted for, was, are you active? And with that being said, I just want to leave that there for y'all, and I want to thank y'all for nominating me as your Democratic candidate for State Senator, District 8. Thank you.